Introducing Deep Trekker's new ROV-powered tether reel, bringing a new level of efficiency to single-operator missions in a variety of subsea applications. Are you looking to bring your daily ROV operations to the next level? With the ROV-powered tether reel, automatically pay out and rewind tether, maximizing efficiency, saving your company time and money while making it easier on your pilots. The new Deep Trekker ROV-powered tether reel, the new solution for single-operator missions. The reel is equipped with a power switch, indicator lights, a rocker switch to both rewind and pay out tether, an Ethernet port, an emergency stop, 6-pole connector for Jetson and Bridgebox connectivity, ROV controller port, charging port. To charge the reel, take the female end of the power cable and plug it into the powered tether reel. Next, take the male end of the power cable and plug it into your topside power source. Once the reel is finished charging, the indicator lights will turn from red to green. The reel also has a level wind and a tensioning knob. When setting your desired tension, ensure the outer knob does not extend past the gearbox. Once you've set your desired tension, use the locking ring to lock them together. The included level wind will both count tether as it passes through, as well as wrap back onto the reel evenly. This will help with distance accuracy for linear inspections as well as tether management. If we would like to temporarily disengage the powered mechanism of the reel, we can do so by disengaging this cog right here. Start by pulling out the pin and push the mechanism to the left until the cog fully disengages. The reel will now function the same as a Deep Trekker manual tether reel. To re-enable the powered function, pull the pin and move the mechanism to the right. You may need to rotate the tether reel slightly in order for the cog to fully re-engage. Let's hook up the reel. Start by taking your controller harness. Plug the female end of the 4-pole controller harness into the controller port. Ensure that no threads are showing and that no wiggle or play is left in the harness. Next, take your controller and plug the other end of the harness into it. Once your controller is hooked up, switch on your reel and wait for the green flashing light to turn solid. Then, power your controller on. Alternatively, the reel can be hooked up with an Ethernet cable. Plug one end into the reel and plug the other end into the center Ethernet port located on the rear of the controller. This will function the same as the 4-pole controller harness. Once hooked up, switch on our tether reel's power switch and once again wait for the flashing green light to turn solid. Turn on the controller using the power button. Now that the controller is connected, let's connect the tether reel to the ROV. Start by pressing the bottom of the rocker switch in order to pay out some tether. By doing this, it will give yourself some slack and allow it to be easier to plug in the ROV. Plug the end of the tether reel into the ROV's connection port. Ensure the tether connector has no wiggle or play and that no threads are showing. Slot the pegs of the stress relief bracket into the ROV's frame and attach it with the supplied cotter pins. Once again, press the bottom of the rocker switch to pay out some additional tether to ensure we have enough slack for a safe deployment. All that's left is to disable the ROV's motors, and it's time for the big splash. While the operator pilots the ROV-powered tether reel, automatically pays out tether, reducing drag on your ROV's thrusters. When ready to retrieve your ROV, press the top of the rocker switch and watch your ROV start to wind directly towards you. While this is convenient, let's take a look at a method that achieves maximum efficiency. This entails setting a programmable button on our Deep Trekker bridge controller. Start by opening the main menu, open up Settings, Controller, and shuffle your way down to input mapping. Once open, click Program Buttons, and now all we have left to do is set a button to our tether reel. Now that our program button has been set, while we are out piloting, upon desired retrieval, simply push the button, and next thing you know, the ROV will be coming straight home. Literally, straight home. Entanglement hazards still exist, please be careful.